So this is a duck egg. This is a video about birds that are trying to hatch and they're not hatching correctly into the air cell. This is the line I drew, I guess it was yesterday, and I did make a little air hole because I do that with all my birds that are hatching unless they just hatch so quickly on their own that I don't end up doing it. But usually if they've internally pipped for a little while, I just go ahead and make a tiny hole like that. And that's just how I do it. So this one, you can see kind of how the air cell, it's almost too bright. The air cell's kind of like a funny shape. It's kind of saddle shaped, and then there's like a big dip over here. And that's actually where I thought he was internally pipped when I made the little air hole for him. Him or her. And there's some more shadowing on this side that I wish it was easier to see with my camera, but it's just kind of a funny shape. Like it's just really far back at the top, and it just often when they look like that, it's because the bird is backwards and they're kicking with their feet and moving with their body in such a way trying to pip that it just kind of makes everything kind of come away from the shell more, and it ends up giving this really weird kind of shape. Try and do this like this. So that's what I thought was the internal pip, is that bump right there actually, because it kind of looks like a beak coming up, but it's probably like a foot. So I turned him over, and I found the bill is actually right in there. Probably it's impossible to tell in the video, but I turned the egg over and actually just looked for, you can see usually it's kind of like a yellowy stain that starts to develop on the egg, and it's actually from the bird pushing with his bill trying to pip, and he's not externally pipped yet, but he's just rubbing the membrane into the shell and it kind of stains it. It's not always very easy to see. I think there you can kind of see it. It's like a really light circle stain. And then when I candled that area, just very faintly in the pink, I could just see an area where there was, it's kind of reddy pink like it would look anyway, but there was also like a little dark spot. It was kind of moving in the shape of a beak. And I've done this so many times now that I just kind of know what that looks like. So I went ahead and just took my needle nose pliers and popped a tiny hole and then just exposed the area where this duck is hatching, because now that he's got air, and I'm going to set him in the incubator like that, now that he's got air, he will hatch the rest of the way by himself. And he maybe would have done that anyway, but I just do this because now I know for sure he's not going to smother in there. I have had them smother when I didn't realize, and especially if the egg is like this, which it should be if he was hatching properly, then this way he's got air, he's not laying on his own head, you know, so it's a little more comfortable for him, and he can take a rest now that I've popped that open. And he chirped quite a bit when I did that because he was probably really excited that I found him. So anyway, that's assisted hatch. I do it because I think if I've stuck a bird in an incubator, then if there's something wrong, it's because something I've done was wrong, or maybe the conditions weren't quite right, or the egg turning wasn't quite right, whatever it happens to be. So I check on them quite a lot, and I do stuff like this whenever it seems necessary, and it's only with fair bit of experience with these sorts of problems that I'm comfortable doing it. But I don't know for sure that this bird would have hatched on his own if I hadn't have done this. So anyway, that's it.